is IOTA, the expedition of Russian rabbits on the lab.
Russian Robinson, the club of traveling radio amateurs. Founded in 1993. Over 900 members from 58 countries. Over 1,000 amateur radio expeditions. Over 300 Russian islands were activated for the Russian Robinson Award program. And over 50 islands for the international program, Islands on the Air. 12 club programs and several million QSO. In 2013, the Russian Robinson Club celebrated its 20th anniversary. Ham radio and geographic expeditions have much in common. What is the philosophy of traveling? Traveling is a breathtaking adventure, discovery, and exploration of remote islands and new shores. The amateur radio hobby may be no less interesting and full of passion. It is especially true about radio expeditions, and the most challenging of them are polar and island endeavors. From its very inception, the Russian Robinson Club has existed with these ideas in the forefront. Russian Robinson presents RRC, spanning between centuries and poles. Yes, Russian islands have been heard on the air well before the foundation of the Russian Robinson Club. The idea of island expeditions has always been here in the radio world. In fact, radio communication was initially demanded mostly where landlines could not be laid. What's more important, ham radio enthusiasts have always sought the chances to explore and to search, be it the DXing or hunting new islands and small countries. It was these exact aspirations that the international radio amateur program, Islands on the Air, launched in Great Britain in 1964, was founded upon. In 2014, the IOTA program marks its 50th anniversary. In Russia, the Islands on the Air program has gained its current popularity due to the activities of the Russian Robinson Club, and IOTA has served as the example for the Nationwide Russian Robinson Award, RRA. The 1980s was the time when many current radio amateurs bought or assembled their first gear. That was the time when many polar expeditions were dispatched by the Soviet Union. Many professional radio operators from the polar expeditions were also radio amateurs. So their polar stations became represented on the air with ham call signs. Some polar posts even ran collective radio stations. These Soviet drifting stations at the North Pole were considered to be highly sought after call signs for radio amateurs all over the world. It was at this time when the memorial diploma named after the legendary Ernst Krenkel was at the peak of its popularity. Later, in Novosibirsk, the Arctic Club was created, and it was the prototype of the future RRC. Under the auspices of the Arctic Club enthusiasts, they organized and ran radio expeditions to polar latitudes and to the Arctic Ocean's islands. It was at this time when the Soviet Arctic Diploma was established. In late 80s through the early 90s, many radio amateur expeditions to interesting geographic locations were carried out. At the same time, there were a number of unique expeditions to islands of northern and far eastern seas. For example, the expedition in the Central Arctic by Leonid Labutin, Georgi Chelyants, Pyotr Kostrov. Also worth noting are the expeditions of Valery Sushkov in the Western Arctic. Yuri Zaruba performed a number of island expeditions under the IOTA program in the Eastern Arctic and the Far East. He explored the Kurils, Komandorskaya, and Chantalskaya Islands and visited many islands near Yakutia, Kamchatka, and Chukotka. Many years have passed since then. By now, the number of expeditions has soared by the dozens. We have provided radio support to renowned travelers and have also organized island and polar expeditions such as the Arctic Ocean 2001 search, known as the Lost Islands. Also have performed a few recent radio discoveries of a few islands near Alaska. The cooperation of Russian radio amateurs with the IOTA committee has influenced the island activities in our country in the most positive way and led to the inception of the Russian National Island Program. In this regard, we personally distinguish Mr. Roger Ballister, which has served as the RSGB IOTA manager for over 25 years. The Russians first participated in the RSGB IOTA convention in 1992, with the country represented by Yuri and Irina Zaruba, as well as Yuri Sushki. That event provided a strong impetus to the promotion of Islands on the Air in Russia. In the 1990s, the island movement emerged in contemporary Russia with the official foundation of the Russian Robinson Club in 1993. Valery Sushkov, RW3GW, was elected as president. Yuri Zaruba, UA9OBA, became the senior vice president of the RRC. The key concept beneath the club's foundation came from the fictional character Robinson Crusoe. The basic list of the Russian section of IOTA was expanded by islands in major seas and inland lakes. This is how the Russian Robinson Award emerged. Other club programs appeared later. The Russian Lighthouse Award, Russian Mountain Award, Russian Arctic Stations Award, Russian Antarctic Bases Award, Russian Maritime Mobile Award, Russian Aircraft Mobile Award, Russian Flora Fauna Award, the Russian Internal Islands Award. Standalone diplomas were introduced for activation of Russian islands, including Franz Josef Land Award, Baikal Islands Award, and a number of others. The initial period of the club's existence in 1993 to 1994 was full of events. All over the entire country, from the Baltic to the Barents Seas, call signs with the RRC suffix were on the air. The first international presentation of the RRC took place in 1994 on the ham radio exhibition in Friedrichshafen, Germany. The club was represented by RW3GW, UA90BA, UY5X-ray Echo, and the first president of the Russian Radio Amateurs Union, Valery Agabekov. The Russian Robinson Club gained international recognition and became a renowned peer among other top European and American radio amateur organizations. Mr. Gianni Varetto was appointed as the international coordinator of the club. Later, Mr. Rolf Rane became the club's coordinator in Germany and even launched the dedicated radio station Delta Lima Zero Robinson Club. Every autumn, the club held the conferences attended by not only the Robinsons, but also by DX contest men. Awards were handed out in various nominations. One of the long-lived traditions became football games between symbolic teams of IOTA and DXCC. The conferences went live on the air with unique call signs, RI3OTA, RI9OTA from Novosibirsk, while the 10th anniversary conference had the call sign Radio 10 Russian Robinson Club. In 2002 to 2009, the club held the World Robinson Cup, an island activation marathon, whose rating accounted for results of national island programs of many world countries. Since 2010, a new island contest, the Russian Robinson Cup, has been launched. It is intended to promote expedition projects both for island hunters and for travelers in the framework of the RRC diploma program. At the moment, the Russian Robinson Club unites over 900 radio amateurs from several dozen countries, about a dozen collective radio stations, and about two dozen radio watchers. The club membership includes renowned travelers Fyodor Konyukhov, R0FK, Vladimir Chukov, R3CA, Nikolai Litau, R3AL/Maritime Mobile, Valentin Yefremov, RA3-TND Portable. The RRC abbreviation has become a recognized brand of our club in the entire radio amateur world. When used as a call sign suffix, it means that a team of Russian Robinsons has embarked on an adventure. S79 RRC.
This is Sierra 79, radio Charlie, portable Charlie.
TF4 RRC. X-ray Victor 3 and 7 RRC. Victor 73 RRC. KL7 RRC. T46 47 48 RRC. The RRC name unites Russian Robinsons all over the world. The information about the club's activities has been collected in the book We Come From the RRC by UY5 X-ray Echo. The club maintains close cooperation with the IOTA committee. We consult people on various islands, spread the information about club projects, represent interests of Russian travelers, and provide RRC memberships to international colleagues. Russian Robinsons do not pursue easy goals. We thrive to visit freezing locations and polar seas, as well as remote uninhabited islands. The majority of Russian islands are located in harsh climatic environment of north and farther eastern seas, which have been the most wanted targets for Soviet and Russian expeditions. The list of inactivated Russian islands under the IOTA program was already exhausted a number of years ago. The last of them, the new one, Asia 174, Shalaurava Island on Chukotka, was radio discovered in 2005 by the Radio Zero Kilowatt Expedition. At present, Russian radio amateurs often embark on expeditions to foreign countries. In order to provide assistance to expeditions under diploma programs, we have created the Russian Robinson Fund. The president of the fund is Sergei Morozov, Radio Alpha 3, November Alpha November. The Russian Robinson Fund calls for cooperation to all those sharing our goals and aspirations. In October 2009, on a regular conference of the club, we discussed ways of further development and reformation of diploma programs, adopted the new charter of the Russian Robinson Club, elected the club's council, and the new executive board of the club. The president of RRC is Yuri Zaruba. The senior vice president is Sergei Morozov. The three vice presidents are Eugene Shelkanovtsev, Andrei Novikov, Georgi Kilyants. Yelena Boychenko is the club's secretary, and Igor Lifshitz is the treasurer. Meanwhile, the Russian Robinson Club was continuing its expeditions and diploma programs. New and rare islands under the IOTA and RRA programs were awaiting their discoverers and activators. In September 2011, the expeditions to Tahiti and to the Marquesas Islands were participated by 5 RRC members. Although we traveled to another side of the globe, to a remote location far away from the major European radio cluster, we performed over 100,000 radio communications on all 9 amateur wave bands. The wide global response was ignited by the expedition Africa 029 to Socotra Island, 7 Oscar 6 Tango. The expedition members performed more than 162,000 communications, and there were 4 members of our club on it. The year 2012 was marked by the club's extreme activities on the Russian North and in the Far East. Despite the numerous flight cancellations, we managed to hold activities at the edge of the world. Radio Italy 0 Kilo from Ratmanova Island, Asia 061, Radio Italy, 0 kilo portable. From Aliumka Island, Asia 092, and KL7 RRC portable from the U.S.-owned Little Diomede Island on the other side of the 4-kilometer-wide Bering Strait. After sailing over 2,200 kilometers in two inflatable boats, RW0BG-9 activated many references under IOTA, RRA, and RLHA. Their endeavor was called the winner in the nomination The Most Extreme 2012 RRC Expedition. In that same year, there was the 10th anniversary of the Russian Lighthouse Award inception and the marathon of R10R LHA station from 21 lighthouses, which could be called a fantastic activity. The year 2013 was also an anniversary year, with the Russian Robinson Club striking the 20-year mark and its members embarking on the expedition to Cuba. Stations T-48 RRC from the Moa Grande Island, T-47 RRC from the Kayakoko, and T-46 RRC from the Santa Maria Island ended up with over 35,000 communications from the very rare islands of Cuba, previously inactive on the bands for over 13 years. The race was continued by the anniversary activities with a special call sign R20RRC on a number of Russian islands, from the Lake Ladoga to Sakhalin and Ruski Island. We activated 12 islands, including 11 for the Russian Robinson Award program, 8 island groups for the International IOTA program, 2 lighthouses for the Russian Lighthouse Award, and 4 lighthouses for the global program World Lighthouses on the Air. About 30 RRC members performed over 22,000 communications during these activities, but the celebration was not over. Besides island expeditions, sometimes there were special calls on the air to commemorate the RRC anniversary. From India, AT20 RRC. Croatia, 9A20 RRC. Germany, DL0 RRC. Alaska, KL7 RRC. Bulgaria, LZ20 RRC. Ukraine, EO20 RRC and EM20 RRC. Over 50 radio amateurs around the world celebrated the activities of our club by more than 25,000 radio communications. To commemorate such important and landmark activities, our club established the anniversary diploma and the plaquette RRC 20 years. More than 500 radio amateurs have already received these commemorative awards. Despite the difficulties, Sergei RA3NAN and Valentin RA3TND performed flights on the balloon St. Russia and performed QSOs with the call sign Radio 3 Russian Robinson Club / Aircraft Mobile over the Arkhaim, an archaeological site situated in the southern Ural steppe, just to the north from the Kazakhstan border, dating back to the 17th century BC. It used to be a settlement of the Shantashta Petrovka culture and is also called Russia's Stonehenge and a puzzle of the ancient world. By then, the anniversary year 2013 was coming to an end. The bombastic opening of that year demanded a grand finale, and we did that. On December 17th through the 31st, the club held the final activity devoted to its 20th anniversary, and it was in Antarctica. The RRC members, Alexander Kuznetsov, Radio Whiskey 3, Radio November, and Oleg Neruchev, the head of the Russian Antarctic Station, went on the air with the anniversary call sign Radio Italy 20 Alpha November Tango from the Russian Antarctic Station, Bellingshausen, on the King George Island, a part of the South Shetland Islands. The flag of the Russian Robinson Club, which had seen many other continents and exotic islands, was raised near the Bellingshausen Station. In order to implement this activity, Alexander Radio Whiskey 3 Radio November on December 10 embarked from the Argentinian town of Ushuaia on the Sea Explorer vessel. During this travel, Alexander performed QSOs from onboard the vessel. Over a short period of time, he carried out more than 1,000 communications with all continents of the world. It was a genuine grand finale of the very successful anniversary year. Robinsons continue to perform expeditions to the rarest and the most remote parts of our beautiful and still unexplored planet. We are open for cooperation. We love challenges. We value friendship very highly. Members of the Russian Robinson Club, together with radio amateurs from other countries, welcome the 50th anniversary of the international program Islands on the Air. We congratulate our colleagues on this event. Where will we go next?